Welcome to The Chef's Kitchen. I'm your host, Nicole Gaffney, and we're here at the PBS 39 studios at the Steel Stacks campus in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. And we're here today with Chef Michael Adams. He's the executive chef of the historic Hotel Bethlehem. Thanks for being here.
Great to be here again.
So what's on the menu today?
We are doing a nice duck breast. We're going to make a pear chutney, and then we're going to finish it with a caramelized star anise sauce.
Excellent. So let's get started.
So, all right. So, we're just going to start off with by breaking the duck down. So, this is a white Peking duck. Mm-hmm. It's just my duck of preference. Very tender meat. Of course, that depends on how you cook it. But it is a great duck to use. So, what we're going to do is we're just going to take the legs off first. And what I typically do with the legs is I'll make duck confit. So
nice.
We'll submerge that in a lot of duck fat,
and
And then simmer that for like 2.5 hours. But we want to take the breast off.
Okay, where do you get your duck from?
We use a farm, Dr. Joe's Duck in Chartlesville.
Dr. Joe.
Yes, Dr. Joe, and a couple other local suppliers, smaller farms. Locally, when I can get them.
Excellent.
So I can't get them as frequently, but.
And you would like to work with as much local.
Absolutely.
Produce and meats and seafood as possible.
Absolutely. As a matter of fact, I stopped to get some of the ingredients this morning from a good friend of mine at Liberty Gardens in Coopersburg.
So this stuff is pretty fresh then.
Yeah, very fresh. So we're just going to take the duck breast off,
mm-hmm.
and then we're going to trim some of the excess fat off of there.
Use that for the confit?
Sure, and you can fry French fries in it,
and you
can do lots of things in it. Anything with duck fat.
Yeah, potatoes especially.
Yeah, no doubt. So we just have the trim that up a little bit,
mm-hmm.
and take the other side off.
And you always like to start with a whole duck and break them down?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And we'll roast the bones
nice.
And make, we already pre-made a duck stock from all the roasted bones.
Oh, you can see how gelatinous that is.
Yep.
I thought that was the pear.
Yeah. No. And so we're just going to take this other breast off here.
Great. And I see the breasts you have over here are a lot bigger.
Yeah, so we get different sized ducks mm-hmm. depending on what application. So we'll use the smaller size for appetizers.
Okay.
And then for entrees, we use the larger sized duck.
Makes sense.
Yep. So, all right. So then what we do is we'll score the duck breast, the top of the duck breast.
And that's really important when you cook duck, right?
Absolutely. It just helps render most of the fat off. Mm-hmm. It allows that heat to penetrate in there and render the fat nice, so you get a nice crispy duck breast.
It's all about the crispy skin.
Stay tuned for more from the Hotel Bethlehem. We're back with more from the Hotel Bethlehem.
Now, do you recommend using a non-stick pan when you do this, or does it really matter?
It's not necessary. There's going to be so much fat in the pan,
mm-hmm.
it's not really going to stick.
All right.
So,
and you want a pretty high heat with this?
So you start on high heat,
mm-hmm.
and then you want to slowly render the fat.
Okay.
You don't want to, you don't want to burn the skin. So
sure.
We're going to turn that down a little bit, and we're just going to leave that render.
Oh, look how much fat's already come out.
You see that?
Yeah, it's crazy.
There's a ton of fat coming out of there. And so what we're going to do, we're going to let that go for approximately 4 or 5 minutes till about 70% of the duck fat is rendered off. And we're going to pour a little bit of that off. There's going to be way too much fat in there.
Okay.
And then what we're going to do is we'll take that and we're going to baste that a little bit right in the pan.
Nice.
So as you're doing this, we're going to finish it in the oven. You can finish it if you have the time. You can finish it right here on the stovetop.
Mm-hmm.
Just requires a lot more basting, a little more time and attention.
Got to babysit a little.
No doubt. And so then you see, look at that, all that fat. So we're just going to take the duck. I also use this cooking technique for cooking fish.
Mm-hmm. So you never flip it?
I never flip it,
okay.
Not once, even when I put it in the oven. We're just going to continue to baste it.
And that's going to let you get that really nice crispy skin, which is my favorite.
All right, so we're going to continue. Let's just baste this a little more.
Mm-hmm. And that's going to keep it really moist, too.
Yep. So you see that? It's getting really nice golden brown on there. And at the same time, we're slowly cooking.
And what temperature do you usually serve duck at?
So I usually do it medium. Mm-hmm. You know, medium rare I think is a little too chewy.
Yeah.
So I like it just slightly pink. Mm-hmm. And you can see how this is as the duck fat. It's cooking, you know.
Yeah.
It's just cooking the breast
really
with the
fat.
Really
gently over top.
So we're just going to keep doing that until we're at about 70%.
Wow.
And then we'll get onto the sauce and the chutney. So you see that? It's getting nice and nice and golden brown.
Great color on that.
So at this point, what we can do is I'm going to pour a little bit of the excess fat off.
Okay. And we'll fry our french fries in that
absolutely.
A little bit.
And then what we're going to do is we're just going to take a little bit of smashed garlic clove. I'm going to smash
that. Release the oils a little.
A little bit of garlic and a little bit of thyme. And then we're just adding a little more flavor. We're just going to leave that in there now and smell that.
Oh,
it just smells.
Totally smell that. So tell me a little bit about Historic Hotel Bethlehem.
So we are a small boutique hotel with 128 rooms.
Oh, nice.
We have two restaurants, 1741, and we also have the Tap Room restaurant, which is a little more comfort food.
Oh, nice.
Our 1741 Terrace is our fine dining restaurant.
And you're the chef of both?
I am.
Great.
Yes. And we also have 14,000 square feet of banquet space. So we have our grand ballroom for weddings. We have small rooms for business meetings and small business dinners, as well as wedding receptions and showers, bridal showers,
excellent.
Corporate events. So
very
really nice.
Nice
balanced hotel.
We also have a wonderful shop, the shop at Bethlehem.
We do.
All kinds of wonderful things there.
Yes.
And then the ice cream parlor, that's my favorite part. It's got a really cool kind of 50s style going on.
Yeah, espresso and cappuccino in there. And over the winter, we had this awesome hot chocolate that I, of course, made. As you can see, we're about 70%.
Yeah.
You see that?
Oh, yeah.
So now I'm just going to finish this in the oven at 325, and I'm going to leave it in there for about 4 minutes.
Lower temp.
Yep, 325.
And why do you do it at such a low temperature? Is that so the bottom doesn't burn?
So, no, it's just the higher the temperature, it's going to expand so quick, and then you have to be more cautious about the timing. So lower temp, slower, you're going to retain all those juices at a lower temperature.
Beautiful.
Okay, so now we're going to get into the, we're going to start the chutney for the duck. And so we're just going to do some pears here and a little bit of onion, fresh ginger root. And so we're just going to peel the pear a little bit.
I like the flavor combinations you have going on here, really aromatic.
Yeah, the bay leaves and the thyme and the star anise. And
fresh bay leaves make a big difference too, I've noticed.
Absolutely. We just have the peeled pear here.
Take care
of that. Sure, thanks. And we're just going to do a small dice. I always like to just, you know, level off the sides a little bit so
makes
you have a
easier.
Nice work surface for the pear so it doesn't roll around. And then we're just going to do a small dice on these.
Now, do you want a ripe pear? This seems like it's got a little
bit
of bite to it.
So, not for this particular dish because, you know, that we're going to cook the chutney for a little while, so you want a firm pear so you don't want it to turn to mush.
Excellent knife skills.
Oh, thank you very much.
I can tell you
I've
get
been
your
doing
practice
it.
In.
I've been doing it for a little while. A few years.
How long have you been a chef for?
Let's see. Oh, geez. I don't even know.
You can make it
let's
up.
See. I started cooking, you know, very young age at home, of course. But I went to a culinary institute. I graduated from there in 1991. So what is that? Professionally, 23 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
You don't look like you're a day over 23.
I don't feel a day over 23.
Now, is this something that's on the menu?
So we'll do this for our fall menu.
Okay.
It's not currently on the menu, but we'll do this as a fall dish.
So you change things up seasonally?
Absolutely.
Great.
Six times a year, we'll change the menus.
Oh, wow.
You know, and we're always running, you know, additions to the menu.
Sure.
And, so we're just going to take a little bit of this ginger root, and we're going to slice it real thin.
It smells great.
And we're gonna sweat these. So one thing I wanted to do first is for the raisins, just so that they're nice and plump, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a bay leaf in here, and I'm just gonna pour a little bit of hot water over these just to reconstitute them and to add a little bit of flavor to the raisin before we use it in the chutney.
I love that idea, and putting the bay leaf in there.
And then we're gonna take just a pinch of salt, and then I'm gonna just add a cinnamon stick, and I'm just gonna let those steep, so then the raisins aren't just the raisin, you're adding those two other dimensions to it.
Great.
And making that flavorful before you even use it in the chutney.
Stay tuned for more with Chef Michael Adams. We're back with Chef Michael Adams of the Hotel Bethlehem.
Now, I understand this recipe has been featured in Lehigh Valley Style magazine.
Yes, it was a fall feature.
Nice.
And the people who have it really enjoy it. So we're just gonna, the pan's a little too hot, so we're just gonna let that cool down a little bit. And then we're gonna just take a little bit of onion.
Just a regular old
yellow
onion
here. Yeah, just a Spanish onion, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you ever cook with sweet onions at the restaurant?
Always, yeah. Cipollinis, mm-hmm. You know, leeks. Spring onions are in right now.
Great. Finally starting
those.
To get a little bit of the seasonal produce.
Absolutely. You know, fiddlehead ferns are in right now.
Cool.
So everything's
they're
starting.
A fun ingredient.
Yeah. So we're just gonna do a small dice on the onion.
So this is like a real savory chutney.
Yep. And everything marries really well together.
Great.
Okay, so I'm gonna check on the duck.
I can hear it sizzling away.
So what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna baste that a little bit again.
Mm-hmm. It smells really good. You get that hit from the garlic.
And I'm just gonna leave that rest as is.
All
and
right.
We'll continue to baste that for a few minutes. So now for the chutney, we're gonna add a little bit of that rendered duck fat to the pan.
Nice.
And then all we're gonna do is lightly caramelize the pears, the onions, and the ginger.
Mm-hmm. Now I hear you guys do a really killer brunch over there at Hotel Bethlehem.
We do. We're actually one of the top 100 brunches,
wow,
according to Open Table in the country.
That's saying something.
And our Easter brunch was awesome.
Nice.
You did really nice dishes. And so the chutney, we're just going to lightly caramelize this.
Mm-hmm.
And while that's caramelizing, let's do a little more basting. Now that these have been steeping for a while, they're nice and
mm-hmm.
soft and plump now.
Fine.
We're just gonna strain those off, and you can see that, right? Did they pick up a little bit of the cinnamon and the bay leaf in there?
A little bit, subtle,
yeah,
but it's there.
Yeah, and it should be mm-hmm. subtle. It shouldn't overpower.
Right.
You still want that true raisin flavor. You just
totally.
Wanna kinda add a little bit to that.
And you do want these to brown a little bit and lightly
yep,
caramelize?
Lightly caramelize. So what I'm gonna do now is while that's cooking, we're gonna start our star anise sauce.
Okay.
I'm just gonna take a little bit of water here.
What's that for?
So this is gonna be for the star anise sauce.
Mm-hmm.
We're just gonna, it's gonna, a little bit of water to evenly caramelize the sugar.
Okay.
So we're gonna put that on high. And we're gonna start with the sugar. And then we're just gonna lightly caramelize that. Okay, so the chutney, it's lightly caramelizing here. I'm gonna add some of the raisins. And then the cinnamon stick. Of course, more bay leaf. Just tear that in half.
I like that you're using the cinnamon stick too, because it imparts such a really gentle flavor. When you pour cinnamon over top, I feel like it's really overpowering sometimes.
Absolutely. Okay, so, and we're gonna add a little bit of honey. Just a touch. And a little bit of apple cider vinegar.
Very nice. Yeah, you can smell that vinegar.
And then we're just gonna shut that off.
All right, so that's it.
All right, so that's it. We're gonna just leave that sit here.
And you don't really want to stir that too much, right? Just kind of swirl it around.
No, just swirl it. Otherwise, you're gonna get uneven caramelization in there. And then just, I think we're done with the duck. This, I think, is gonna be a really nice medium rare.
Awesome.
So let's turn that over and look at nice and golden brown.
Wow, look at that skin.
And it's gorgeous. We're just gonna leave that sit another minute.
I love that technique that you use by not flipping the duck. I think that's really cool.
Yeah, it keeps, and you can feel it's gonna be nice and crispy.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. So we have our chutney, and now we're gonna start the sauce here.
Stay tuned for more from the Hotel Bethlehem. We're back with more from the Hotel Bethlehem.
Okay, so we caramelized the sugar. You can see that's really nice and golden brown. We're just gonna add the vinegar now. It's gonna give it a nice sweet and sour flavor to it. And then in the other pan, we're just gonna take some of our aromatics and we're gonna infuse that into some. Now, if you don't have duck stock or you don't have time to make the duck stock, chicken is fine, or vegetable stock, that's fine. Of course, with duck, you're gonna have a lot more flavor.
Sure.
But we're just gonna sweat the shallots a little bit.
That you wouldn't want to use like a beef or a veal stock for this application?
You know what? I think beef is a little bit too strong and veal's a little bit too strong.
Yeah.
I think for duck and this particular dish, I think it would take away from kind of the balance of the chutney and everything else. So we're just going to get a light sweat on the shallots.
Okay.
Lightly caramelizing is okay. And then all we're going to do is take some peppercorns.
Mm.
And again, a few peppercorns. And our star anise, put that in, cinnamon stick, and then we're going to add our duck stock.
Now star anise is really strong. I see you put a lot in there.
Yeah, I mean once you add the stock, it's just going to simmer for about 5-6 minutes.
Wow, look at how gelatinous that is, made with a lot of bones.
All right, so we're just going to simmer that for a minute. And reduce it down.
Mm-hmm.
And a pinch of salt right here. Okay, so you want to cook this vinegar down until it gets to it's almost going to look like sugar again. So you want to cook that almost all the way down. When the bubbles get to the size of about a nickel, then we'll add the stock to the sauce. So now we're going to add the infused stock to here.
Mm-hmm. So that really infuses for just a couple minutes.
Yeah, it just has to steep. All those ingredients are really strong. So
right.
And then we're just going to reduce that down to sauce consistency.
Oh wow, you can really smell the star anise already.
So let's take a taste. You want a taste?
Why, thank you. I'd love to.
Now it's not there yet, but let's see where it is as far as flavor, and then if it reduces.
It's nice, sharp.
Right?
Yeah.
And I like that acid because the chutney is somewhat sweet.
Right.
It's going to cut through the sweetness of that. So the duck is ready. It's been resting. And that's really important. Keep the duck resting for about 4 to 5 minutes. And we're just going to let that sit over there and
serve that sliced.
Yep. And we are about ready in another minute. And that sauce
will
be ready.
Finish the sauce with anything, or that's just it?
That's it. That's
gorgeous.
The sauce, yeah.
Great.
And now we can start plate up. So let's start with the chutney. Put that down on the plate here.
So the chutney is almost going to act as a little bit of the sauce, but also the veg too,
both,
I guess.
Yep. And that sauce is ready. You can see how it's just about nappé.
Yep.
Right?
Are you using this towel?
No.
Okay. You can hear the skin when you slice through that little crackle. Beautiful.
And you see, nice
That's
and
perfect.
Pink, perfect medium.
Perfect. Yep.
And then we're just gonna fan that onto the chutney. And a touch of the sauce.
Yeah, it thickened up quite a bit.
So a little bit on the edge of the duck, and then a rest around.
And the thickness is really just from the sugar.
Yep. And the gelatin, of course, is going to assist with that.
Definitely.
Some of the sugar. All right. And we have our roasted duck breast.
Beautiful.
With star anise sauce and pear chutney.
Okay, great. Well, I'm dying to try this. Cheers. I'll give you a knife.
Thank you.
Let's dig in. I'm going to go for this crispy end piece.
All right.
Don't be shy.
I'm going to go for the center cut.
I have to come visit you at Historic Hotel Bethlehem and give this a try for sure.
Look forward to it.
I will see you there.
Great.
We'll have you back here on the Chef's Kitchen again soon.
Look forward to it.
All right, great. Yes. Thanks.
The Lehigh Valley's premier hotel, Historic Hotel Bethlehem, is perfect for any stay. Offering two restaurants by notable chef Michael Adams, 1741 on the Terrace, an upscale dining experience, and the Tap Room, a casual restaurant. Guests enjoy 24-hour room service, along with the Shop at Hotel Bethlehem, featuring Penn State Creamery ice cream, and offering the finest in accessories. Two beautiful ballrooms and ample meeting space make Historic Hotel Bethlehem the place to host your next event. Stay with us at Historic Hotel Bethlehem and feel at home.